Now, let us talk about properties of magnetic lines. I am calling it B vector lines of forces. Remember that in the beginning of this lecture, we said that this particular topic is also called magnetostatics. That means the electric lines of forces, or you must say electrostatic lines of forces, whatever kinds of properties they had, more or less you can say similar to those properties you have here. Before I start writing their properties, it will be very nice in case you draw the magnetic lines of forces due to a bar magnet. If let us suppose for the sake of clarity, I am drawing a large magnet this way. You have a south pole here. You have a north pole here. If you draw the magnetic lines of forces, you will be having magnetic lines going something like this. Inside, they are going from south to north. You can have similar kind of situation here. Some of the lines you can show this way. Inside, you will be finding they are moving from south to north, but outside they are moving from north to south. These are the kind of magnetic lines of forces you have inside and outside of bar magnet. You can see the lot of similarity between electric lines of forces and magnetic lines of forces. If let us suppose you had a negative charge here and positive charge here, the only difference was the magnetic lines inside, but outside they were having this kind of field lines only. Now the first property, if you correlate with the electric lines of forces you have, then the first thing we will say that mu naught number of lines originate from unit positive magnetic charge or magnetic pole strength. This is the first property you should understand, and you can completely recap that this is on the line of electrostatic lines. In electrostatics, you said that 1 by epsilon naught number of lines originate from unit positive charge. Now you know that mu naught and 1 by epsilon naught, they are analogous to each other. So on the similar line, you should understand that mu naught number of lines originate from unit positive magnetic pole strength M. This is completely analogous to the properties you had for electrostatic lines of forces. Now remember that some of the properties are exactly same, some of the properties are exactly different from electric field. So you will find there are on the whole three properties which are different from electric field, but rest of the properties of magnetic lines are exactly similar to that we have learnt in electric field. Now as a second property, you should understand that unlike electric field, if you try to remember electric field lines, they start at a particular point. Say you had a positive charge here plus Q and you had minus Q here. In between, the lines, electric lines, were something like this. They started from some point, they terminated at some particular point. Outside you had lines the same way you have written here, you had drawn here. They were forming loop like this from this side. But the problem with electric lines is that they start at particular point and they terminate. But no, this kind of thing will be seen here. Unlike electrostatic lines, you can say magnetic lines always form closed loops. So let us write down. The second property you have Unlike electrostatic lines, the magnetic lines of forces always form closed loops. इलेक्ट्रिक लाइन्स एक पॉइंट से स्टार्ट होकर दूसरी पॉइंट पे टर्मिनेट हो सकती है, वो लूप नहीं फॉर्म करती हैं, इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक लाइन्स रादर. लेकिन मैग्नेटोस्टैटिक लाइन्स जो आप देख रहे हैं यहाँ पे, ये हमेशा एक क्लोज लूप फॉर्म करती है. एंड यू कैन से दिस इज अ डायरेक्ट कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट मोनोपोल्स डू नॉट एग्जिस्ट. सो यू कैन से दिस इज डायरेक्ट कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट magnetic monopoles do not exist. You understand? चाहे आपने पहला स्टेटमेंट दिया हो चाहे दूसरा स्टेटमेंट दिया हुआ, दोनों बिल्कुल सिमिलर हैं. ओनली थिंग इज द वे ऑफ एक्सप्रेसिंग देम इज डिफरेंट. वेन यू आर सेइंग दैट मैग्नेटिक मोनोपोल्स डू नॉट एग्जिस्ट, then this is also another way of saying that magnetic lines will be forming loops. And in case you try to express these things in terms of Gauss's law in magnetism, agar isi ki direct consequence dekhen, then we can say that Gauss's law in magnetism will be, of course Gauss's law in magnetism likhne ke liye you should try to recapitulate how did you write Gauss's law in electrostatics. Gauss's law in electrostatics mein aapne likha tha integral E dot ds is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the net charge enclosed, if you remember. So here also analogous to electrostatics, if I write Gauss's law in magnetism, then instead of E dot ds, I will be writing it as integral B dot ds. You understand? Bilkul analogous expression maine likha hai. For E dot ds, I have written down B dot ds. Wahan pe 1 by epsilon naught thi, to yahan pe ye mu naught ho jayegi. Aur Q net tha, to Q net ki jagah pe aap net magnetic charge likhenge. This is the Gauss's law in magnetism. But problem is that monopoles are not existing. Ye expression tab ho jayegi jab monopoles exist karte hote. Sometimes we ask you to write down Gauss's law in magnetism had monopoles been existing. Agar monopoles exist karti to kuch magnetic charge net ho sakta tha, jaise electric charge ki kuch net value ho jati hai. But here since net magnetic charge does not exist, jahan pe bhi plus m hoga wahan pe minus m hoga. So net magnetic charge is always zero. So the realistic Gauss's law in magnetism is that integral B dot ds, this is equal to zero. This is the second property of magnetic lines of forces. And yahan pe essentially maine three types of statements likhi hain, but believe me, all three are one of the same thing. Unko kehne ke tarike alag hain, but all three mean the same thing, that monopoles do not exist. However, there is no theoretical foundation. प्रैक्टिकली आज तक हमने मैग्नेटिक मोनोपोल्स डिस्कवर नहीं किए, बट देर इज नो थियोरिटिकल रिस्ट्रिक्शंस दैट मोनोपोल्स कैनॉट एग्जिस्ट, दे मे. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस द थर्ड प्रॉपर्टी. इफ यू रिमेंबर इन इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स हमने कहा था कि इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक लाइन्स ऑफ फोर्सेज कभी भी कंडक्टर के अंदर से पास नहीं करती हैं. यू हैड ऑलरेडी सीन वी हैड केप्ट अ कंडक्टर इन साइड एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, और वहाँ पर अंदर में इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड आपने जीरो देखी थी, विच यू ऑल्सो कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक शील्डिंग. But this kind of restriction is not there in magnetic field. यहाँ पर अगर magnetic field को देखें तो आप conductor के अंदर देख सकते हैं कि वो magnetic field exist कर रही है. You can have some different situations in which you will see that electrostatic lines से different. Electrostatic lines से different कुछ property हम यहाँ पर देख सकते हैं. कहते हैं कि if you have a soft iron ring, let us suppose this is a soft iron ring I have drawn. In case you keep soft iron ring in a magnetic field, then you will find that inside the ring magnetic field is zero. You understand? अगर soft iron ring आप देखें तो उसके अंदर magnetic field zero हो सकती है. अगर आप एक super conductor देखें, let us suppose this is super conductor. This is also called Meissner effect. एक सुपर कंडक्टर को अगर आप मैग्नेटिक फील्ड में रखेंगे देन यू विल फाइंड दैट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस दे डू नॉट प्रेफर टू पास थ्रू अ सुपर कंडक्टर. सुपर कंडक्टर के अंदर में हर जगह पे मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जीरो होती है. सो यू हैव सीन दैट इनसाइड अ कंडक्टर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जीरो हो भी सकती है एंड इनसाइड अ कंडक्टर हियर द बार मैग्नेट विच यू हैव शोन दैट इज ऑल्सो अ कंडक्टर यहाँ पे मैग्नेटिक लाइन्स एग्जिस्ट कर सकती हैं. So if you see the third property of it, you can say if you write down the third property, you can say that unlike electrostatic lines, the B lines, magnetic lines of forces may or may not pass through a conductor. You understand? This is the second difference between electrostatic lines and magnetostatic lines. Electric lines ke liye restriction hai, they will not be passing through a conductor, but magnetic lines may pass through a conductor or may not pass through a conductor. May pass through a conductor ki example humne yahan show ki hai and may not pass through a conductor ki example humne yahan show ki hai. On the basis of this soft iron ring, when you see that magnetic lines are not passing, sometimes we also ask you a question, why magnetically sensitive instruments are kept inside a soft iron ring? Reason is very much clear, that if you keep magnetically sensitive instrument inside soft iron ring, then they will not be affected by external magnetic field, they will not be damaged. So here we have shown that magnetic lines may not pass through a conductor, and here we have shown that magnetic lines may pass through a conductor. Now a third dissimilarity jo electrostatic lines or magnetic lines ke beech mein hoti hai. Electrostatic lines ke liye hamesha humne ek restriction dali hai ki they will be perpendicular to the conductor. Electric lines of forces are always perpendicular to the surface from which they start or where they meet. But इस तरह की कोई restriction magnetic lines के साथ नहीं है. आप अगर इस diagram को देखें तो यहाँ पे magnetic lines almost perpendicular है, but if you look at these situations, यहाँ पे magnetic lines are not really perpendicular to the surface from which they are starting or where they are meeting. यहाँ से ये start कर रही है, यहाँ meet कर रही है, they are not really perpendicular. You understand? This is the third major difference between electrostatic lines and magnetostatic lines. So we will write that. The next property we are writing is that unlike electrostatic lines, the magnetic lines need not be perpendicular to the surface from which they start or where they meet. You understand? So these are the three main differences you have seen between electrostatic lines and magnetic lines. The first property I wrote that was analogous to electrostatic lines, but next three properties which I have written, they are completely different from what we have seen in electrostatic lines. Now rest of the properties of magnetic lines which we will see, they are exactly analogous to the one we have in electrostatic lines. At least two more similarities we will be writing: magnetic lines of forces. Magnetic lines of forces do not cross each other. This is the kind of property you have for electrostatic lines as well. वहाँ पे ये प्रूव भी करने को आता है हमें कि हाउ कैन यू जस्टिफाई दैट इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक लाइंस आर नॉट क्रॉसिंग ईच अदर. वहाँ पे आपने बताया था कि द पॉइंट ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन आप अगर लेंगे तो टेंजेंट टू दैट शोज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक लाइंस. तो क्रॉस सेक्शन पे देर विल बी टू डिफरेंट डायरेक्शंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक लाइंस व्हिच इज नॉट रियली पॉसिबल. सो ऑन द सिमिलर लाइंस हियर ऑल्सो यू कैन जस्टिफाई दिस स्टेटमेंट दैट मैग्नेटिक लाइंस ऑफ फोर्सेज विल नॉट बी क्रॉसिंग ईच अदर. एंड अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी यू हैव फॉर इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक लाइंस दैट वॉज wherever you had crowding of lines, that essentially indicated that the magnitude of electric field there is more. So similar kind of expression we have for magnetostatic lines as well, that crowding of magnetic lines, crowding of magnetic lines of forces indicates the larger magnitude of magnetic field. You see, I would like to make it very much clear. Electrostatic lines of forces means that the direction of electric field is the direction of force, but in magnetic lines the force is perpendicular to that. So some of us have the objection whether the magnetic lines should be called as magnetic lines of forces or not. You see, wherever we are writing magnetic lines of forces, we are essentially meaning magnetic lines. We are not talking about forces they are applying. So do not get confused by that. Wherever we have written magnetic lines of forces, they are simply meaning magnetic lines. So like electrostatic lines, you can see here also the crowding of lines will mean larger value of magnetic field existing at that particular point. So these are some of the similarities and dissimilarities between electrostatic lines of forces and magnetostatic lines of forces, based on which we have visualized the properties of magnetic lines of forces. You see here, the B lines of forces are essentially magnetic lines. So this is all in our today's discussion. So before I go ahead, let me summarize what all we have discussed in today's lecture. In today's lecture of properties of bar magnet, first we wrote down analogous expression for bar magnet. Treating it as a magnetic dipole. We wrote down several analogous expressions like Coulomb's law, how a bar magnet experiences a force in a magnetic field, or how electric dipole kind of expression will be written for magnetic dipole on axial line, on equatorial line, how it is experiencing torque or what is the potential energy. all types of expressions we wrote for a bar magnet. We solved some of the examples highlighting the properties and which was analogous to the kind of properties electric dipoles have. And on the second part of the lecture, we discuss various properties of magnetic lines, in which we said that there are some of the properties which are exactly analogous to that in electrostatic lines, but there are some of the properties which are slightly different from what we experience in electrostatics. So this is all we have in our today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will be talking about Earth's magnetism, because Earth is being treated as a large bar magnet, and the kind of properties we have discovered in our today's lecture, similar kind of properties we will be finding for Earth's magnetism as well. Thank you.